This video is part 2 to an already existing video. While you don't need to watch that one to understand this one, I recommend you do, and I also recommend you watch my Albrick Studios rant. So once you watch those two, you'll be completely caught up with what's going on here, but if not, you can probably watch this and get away with it. Let's get into the video. Welcome back to part 2 of what I'm hoping is the final video in this set of Albrick Studios videos. So, to clear this up first, about the point about Jake, Albrick Studios, in this group chat that I got added to with a bunch of people and him on Discord, he clarified that since he used footage of Jake in the Ninjago TV show in the video got monetized by LEGO automatically. Which, he provided proof of that, he was reasonable about it, fair enough. But, when asked about Kirby Moro and monetizing that video, which he's since removed the ads on, no comment. Asked again, no comment. So we unfortunately don't have proof of the Kirby one, because no one screenshotted the ad there, but you can ask, like, literally anyone, and observe the fact that as soon as he's asked about the Kirby situation, he always just dips. And until we have further evidence, I think that's safe to assume. So I just thought I'd clear that up about the point in the video, because if a piece of information isn't true, I don't want to spread it, like, you know? So Al, if you see this, if you want to clear up the Kirby thing after dodging the question twice, then Discord DMs are open, server's open, you can come in and clear it up. So moving on to Al's response video, because there's some stuff in here that I feel like it needs to be covered. So Al talked in his response video about a Discord server he got added to where he received racist abuse and death threats.
Same people that are on Discord, in a group that I'm in. Well, they made this group, and I guess they added me, and they're basically being racist there to me, you know, sending photos of my face, people like Daily Rollord, Overlord X, DP Videos NL, and I guess Overlord X's friends, they're all in that group, and they're just trying to do stuff to me. For those who are hating on me, just remember, what you're doing, do you think it's right? Do you think it's right to make death threats? Do you think it's right to make a group chat and then add me in?
Now, about the racist abuse he claims to have received. I'm in this group chat. What happened is I published the video, and about an hour later, me, Daily, Overlord, and all that had been added to this group chat that these edgy teens, the types who are like, yeah man, I have dark humor, and then just act really racist. Those types of people added us all to a group chat. And then one of them called Albrick Studios the N-word, which I don't condone at all. I don't condone any of that sort of behaviour. I'm not associated with those people, nor will I ever associate myself with people like that. But the death threats are just straight up not true. I did a bit of digging around on that server, because after Al said his bit in that server about the Jake thing, I was like, okay, cool, and left, because I didn't care about being in that group chat. But I joined back to do a little snooping around, and I found that when you look up kill and other death-related words, the word you'd think you'd get when you suggest death threats in that server, nothing. Al had not been death threatened, as far as I can find, whatsoever, yet he claims we were giving him death threats, likely in an attempt for sympathy.
A lot of these accusations are false, I'm just saying.
Now this I find really funny, because he doesn't say which of these accusations are false, he just says, oh yeah, they're lying. It's all lies, none of it's true, guys, don't believe him, he's a non-believing hater who's gonna burn in hell. All of them are false. Make sure you join the Ninja Nation, and you see what I mean? He just, like, he doesn't back this up, like, at all. Instead of trying to back it up, he just dismisses everything that he's been accused of as false. Even the stuff that, for example, that instance of him scamming with the island profile picture. The person who he was trying to scam sent me a picture of the up-to-date screenshots as of now with all the new profile pictures and all that, and yeah, that image is true.
There's a lot of stuff that's taken out of context.
Oh, right, yeah, of course. Those creepy Snapchat messages you sent that later broke the Snapchat friendship you and this person had were just all jokes taken out of context. My bad, man. I didn't consider the fact that you messaging random people asking what sex feels like was just a massive out of context thing. My bad, brother. I honestly don't even know if I want to bother covering this too in depth, because those are literally the only two noteworthy things he says. Literally, all of the rest of it is just him talking about how much he's changed. And then the last third of it, I might upload the full thing separately on my second channel, and if I do, I'll put it in the end cards or pinned comment or whatever. But the rest of the video is two things. I've changed. I'm such a good person, guys. I've changed this time. Ignore that screenshot from November 2020 of me trying to scam someone for $110. I've changed this time, I swear. I promise you. And then the other half of it is, I'm such a good Christian boy. You're all sinners, but I'm such a good little Christian boy. I can't do any wrong. That's the two things he does in this video, and he just mostly does it on loop. Those two things I covered are the only two noteworthy things from it. So as a result, I think that's all we have to cover. I think that's the end of the Albrick Studios videos. So, in conclusion, Al is not a very good person, and I don't think he deserves his platform. Al, if you want to clear up the situation with ads on the Kirby videos, despite how weird it is that as soon as Daily mentioned that at one point you had ads on the Kirby video, you dipped, and when I asked you, you didn't respond. It's pretty weird how quickly you stopped responding, but if you want to clear it up, DMs on all platforms are open. I'm happy to discuss it and make an amendment video for that particular point if need be. But other than that, even if something else comes out, I honestly don't think I'll make another video. I'm not the biggest fan of drama nowadays, and ideally, I didn't want Al to respond because I didn't want to make another Al video, but you know, he did, and there was some stuff I had to cover. But that's hopefully the end of the Albrick Studios saga. I hope, for what it was worth, it was entertaining for you all at the least. And I hope it also educated people who weren't aware about Al's misdeeds, about what he's done and why he's pretty toxic. So, that's it from me. I hope to see you next time in a more normal video. And yeah, that's all from me really. I'll see you next time. I really appreciate all the support and the amount of people who've rallied behind the video. I could not be more thankful for that. The amount of success that video had was completely unprecedented, and it was all down to you guys. Thank you very much. Goodbye.